Starting late, so we're going to start right now. My name is Robert Schmidt. I am the brass ensemble teacher here at Dixie State University, and this is going to be our concert. Brass ensemble on this side. Halfway through, we get a little bit of three solos on this side, and we'll come back to this side. So if you look in your program, you'll notice that each one of us have one instrument listed next to our name. But if you look up here, that's a lot more than one instrument next to most of us. So just so you're aware, we are going to be switching around quite a bit through the concert. We have trumpets. Everybody at one point will play trumpets. Okay? Your nice, lovely B-flat trumpet. A couple of us will be playing on C trumpets. We got our French horns. Yeah. Trombone. Oh, yeah. Well, several of us can play trombone, including a valve trombone. We've got a euphonium.
Okay.
Yep, yep. And a tuba. Did I miss anything?
Drums.
So most of us are playing more than one instrument tonight. It's good to see this many people here. I did a quick count. We've got about 35 people here tonight, maybe a little more now that I started talking and people have walked in. And that's about 35 more than last year. Glad to see you.
I'm Sam Dixon. I see a couple of my students out here. Yeah, hello. This first tune we're going to play was written by George Gershwin when he was 15, 16, and it was the very first piece that he ever had published. It didn't do really well at first, but his piano role that he made for the player piano was actually a really, really awesome role that got really, really popular. So this is Rialto Ripples, George Gershwin's first published piece.
Thank you.
Most of the music we hear is what we refer to as home fun, where it's built on chord structures, vertical chord structures. And before that style came around, Bach and his predecessors, what they would do is they would take melodic lines and interweave them. They would mesh them together. And by doing so, it would create vertical harmony. So it was the other approach. So this piece of music, we call that counterpoint, which literally means note against note or point against point. So we have a four-bar phrase melody, which I'm going to ask Mr. Schmidt to demonstrate so that you'll hear this in A minor. Go ahead, sir. So, as you listen to this, sorry about the long-winded explanation, but these guys need your rest. So we're going to start out with trombone, it goes to French horn, it goes to first trumpet, McKenzie, and then it goes to the low brass, to the trombone. So you'll hear the four entrances. This is a four-voice fugue. Bach was probably considered the master. His art of the fugue is the tour de force of this style of writing, somewhere between 1740 and 1750, which is when he died. So it's a very creative, original title. It's called Contrapuntis. Contrapuntis by Bach.
Thank you. soon, as you can see in the program, is breaking up. It's hard to do. That's by Neil Sedaka. Now, this is written. This arrangement is written for a brass quintet. What's interesting about a brass quintet is it's very transparent. Any instrument that you look at, you should be able to hear play. So if you focus on the trombone, you should hear the trombone player play, or the tuba, whatever. Transparency is difficult in a small ensemble. If you listen to an orchestra with 150,000 violins, you maybe can't pick out that one. But if you want to hear your grandson play a wrong note or something, just listen and you'll hear, or me. So one interesting thing about this is I'm from the Midwest, and there's a vocal trio in the Midwest that has taken this, and all three of these women are in the dental practice. So they took Breaking Up Is Hard to Do, and they changed the title to Dental Floss. Floss is not hard to do. Instead of Breaking Up Is Hard to Do, it's Floss is not hard to do. And they changed all the lyrics, and it's a great fun. So they also took a tune called Thanks for the Memories, and they changed it to Thanks for the Root Canal. So this is Breaking Up Is Hard to Do. I'll play a little drum set on this just to spice it up. I'll be using regular drumsticks, not the turkey drumsticks that you throw in after Thanksgiving.
Thank you. So it's reminiscent, in my opinion, of Very Speedy Wind. And a cool thing about this song is that instead of playing the B-flat trumpet like is with the standard, Rob and I are playing the C trumpet, which looks exactly like the B-flat, unless you look closer. In music, concert pitch is at note C, but trumpets have our standard inch note-based notation is B-flat. So if we wanted to play a song in the concert of C, we'd have to either play a bunch of sharps or flats or transpose in our head. But if you play the C trumpet instead of the B flat, it does the work for you. So it's pretty fun. So this is a trumpet for them.
We're now moving to the next portion. Are you going to talk right here?
No, go ahead.
Okay, I'm talking. We're now moving to the solo portion of this concert, so we'll vacate the stage for a little bit so the soloists can have your undivided attention.
35 year anniversary. And the description of the song, it's a mix of a Gregorian chant, which is old school Catholic chanting music, and also contemporary. So I hope you enjoy this and take the waltz.
Everybody, but guess what? They've already introduced themselves. But I'm going to add just a little bit. So Gary Caldwell, Maestro Gary Caldwell. If you don't know Gary Caldwell, then you haven't lived in St. George very long. Gary Caldwell. That's where I saw your poster last. Gary Caldwell was the band director here from how many years? You don't want to say. 37 years, and also the director of the Southwest Symphony for many, many years. Gary, there's not much more than we say about Gary. Mackenzie Clements, you've already learned that she is not a music major. She's a history major. She will be teaching history coming up soon. Great trumpet player. And what she has in common with Randy Baziner is she has some roots in Utah and some roots in Wisconsin, which is where Randy taught his entire career. In the huge town of
Minocqua,
look it up. Not a whole lot around Minocqua, but he came from
Kansas. His father played in the band when I was here.
Okay.
20-something years ago.
Just before I came here, if I recall right. So Randy Baziner on French horn. If you can spell his last name and you're not related to him, you get extra credit. he lives here sometimes, and he lives in Wisconsin sometimes. And he's got funny, funny, great stories. Jay Dressler on French horn. What you don't know about Jay is he just switched over to French horn. He played saxophone mostly in high school. And he's brand new on the French horn, his first semester, and a music ed major. Is that correct? And Sam Dixon on tuba. His main instrument is really trumpet as well. He's a teacher at Kirkland Intermediate School and a graduate of Dixie High School. Correct?
Yep.
I answered all of that. And I'm Rob Schmidt. My day job is the district arts coordinator of the school district here in town. And now we're going to play our next tune. If you don't recognize this, you probably should leave.
Next one is a more of a ballad, like Bonnie Boy. third one is Folk Songs from Somerset, written in the 20s, 1920s.
Sure.
That sound right, Tim?
Come around there.
Anyway, English Folk Song Suite by Ralph Vaughan Williams. Thank you. Thank you.
That